I've been seeing quite a bit of confusion about tracking sick figs in terms of doing your labs, so hopefully this video will help clear some of that up. I'm just going to work through this example. This should all look familiar. It's basically our conservation momentum lab, just some mock data here. And you can take a quick minute to pause the video to just double check that the calculations are all correct. You will notice that throughout all my calculation, I try to keep as many digits as I can. So that's why you see that at the very bottom here, we have a very long number because no rounding until the conclusion. And I often get asked at this point, well, how many sick figs should I keep in the conclusion? Well, it all traces back to the very beginning, and that's why I have to show you everything you see here. You definitely need to go back all the way to the raw data that the calculation is based on, because the sig fig in the final answer here will depend on the number of sig figs in each of these numbers, which then percolate back up to your actual raw data table. So that's why we encourage you to, even though you're not doing any rounding, you want to underline your last significant digits so that as you do your calculation, it becomes very clear which digits is actually your last significant figure, and so you can apply your sig fig rules much more readily. Looking back at the data table then, how do we decide how many sig figs there are in each number? And of course, that's based on your actual uncertainty. Wherever your uncertainty starts, so leading zeros don't count, so this here is the 2, we get 3 decimal places in my uncertainty then, and so I also have 3 decimal places in my value. That's the relationship. Start with the uncertainty, leading it over to end in the same decimal place. So by the same token, this will be my start of my uncertainty, and so I get 3 decimal places, I get to underline the 4 here. For my time, I have 2 digits in my uncertainty, but I want to find out where the start of it is. So the start is this 2 here. That's the leftmost digits. Leading zeros don't count. This is my first decimal place, so I only get to keep to the first decimal place. So even though I have 3 numbers here, this is only a 2 sig fig number. Similarly, this one, I have to underline the 1. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I end up here, so that's a 4 sig fig number. So now that we've all those underlined, as we go through our calculation, we simply applied our sig fig rules. So we know that these two are underlined. This is a subtraction, so we're caring about decimal place instead of the number of sig figs. So we don't care about that the 0.014 here has 2 sig figs. What we care that it has 3 decimal places. 3 decimal places, 3 decimal places. So the final answer also has 3 decimal places. Underline that. Then we bring this along to the final calculation here, and this is the multiplication. So now we care about the number of sig figs. Again, we put on our underline so everything's nice and clear, and we track the number of sig figs. So here, leading zeros don't count. We have 4 sig figs, multiply by this number, which has 3 sig figs, and this one is 1.1. It ends at the 1, so that's only 2 sig figs. Out of these, we choose the least. And that's why we know our final answer only has 2 sig figs, which means I underline right there. So now it becomes very clear what you should do in your conclusion. In your conclusion, then, the momentum of the cart is we have to round off to the correct digits, and I get to keep 2, 0.25, but then it's a 6 underneath, so I'll round it up to 0.26 units. And that's it. So quick recap, the sig figs in your final answer will depend on everything you use to calculate that particular answer, and eventually tracing back to your raw data, and the number of sig figs in your raw data will ultimately be decided by the uncertainty wherever it starts. So again, we would really like to encourage you to use these underlines to track your sig figs all the way through. That way you're not all confused and trying to work it all out at once at the very end.